to none.
Thank you.
I watched them swallow bodies and then swallow souls. They fed on our flesh and our souls. I did not think they would ever be stopped. I did not think they could ever be stopped. I would have said you had lost your mind, but...
She looks around the chamber, taking in the sea of cracked, broken eggs and dead Voidwoken.
But perhaps... perhaps there is hope. Please, should you find more Voidwoken, slaughter them all.
I've spotted something.
The dwarf sways in front of you. His eyes are unfocused, and he seems to be mumbling something to himself.
84 tankards of beer in a cave, 84 tankards of beer. Pick one up, tip back your cup,
The ghost grasps at the handle of his mug and stares in confusion as his hand passes right through it.
Four tankards of beer. Don't know, that ain't right. Hey, what? I don't know what you mean. I'm just trying to get a grip is all. Just wanted one last tipple before I'm back on duty. I'll be down guarding Mordus. Gets cold down in that vault. Figured a drink or two to guard against the chill wouldn't hurt, eh? Hiding? Ha! He ran to that vault like a rat with his what's it on fire? Tail! It's underneath his office. Ain't no way out. We just sealed him in and posted a guard. And once Loar gets here, he'll deal with him. Won't be pretty, neither. Dead? Who are you trying to fool, mate? I might have been hitting the beer, but I reckon you've had one too many spirits, eh? Eh? Spirits, get it? Nah, I'll just have one more and then I'm off. Just one more.
Thank you.
performing.
Me alive. The little ones, once they burst out of their eggs, they ate me screaming. I don't understand. Why did this happen? Why wasn't the Divine here to save me?
Too little, too late. I'm already dead, and Rivellon's been on its own for too long now.
The spirit's hands are clamped firmly over her ears. Her mouth is firmly closed, and her eyes are squeezed shut. As you reach out, you hear a dry, crackling voice.
Kill the dwarves. They are not your friends. They are not your allies. They must die. They must all die. And when the eggs hatch, when beautiful life bursts forth, give yourself to it. Lay down your head and rest. Your duty will be done. Let them come. Do not fight it. Let them bite you. Let them feed.
You pull away with a jerk, gasping for breath. The dwarf whimpers a little in front of you.
Never thought I'd be relieved to die like that. If you hadn't come along, I would have been eaten by them damn hatchlings we were guarding. I wish I could tell you, but my brain ain't quite straight. It's still full of Mordus's fog. All I know is I were to guard those eggs with my life. And once they cracked open, I was to lay down my weapon and let them eat me. You spared me from that at least. Thank you. Be damned if I know. We had him locked up tight in the hold beneath his office, waiting for Lohar's go-ahead before we threw him off the cliff. Then, the next thing you know, I hear this voice. His voice telling me to kill. And my hand went for my dagger. Be damned if I... Then...
Nice.
Made it all the way here, you creeping little maggots? Have you wriggled up to bow to me? Has Lohar sent you to beg forgiveness for his sins?
Thank you.
My lord had faith. He came to me when Lohar failed the queen. And as a reward for my service, he has granted me his favor. He has granted me Mord'Akaim. Armies? Merely sheep with swords. Minds that beg to be controlled. But Mord'Akaim is so much more than the power to have those beasts slaughter each other. And it is mine. By the Lord's grace, the power is mine.
Down. Thank you for the force I need to become Mord'Akaim.
Thank you. Mercy! Mercy!
The Master Sorcerer throws up his pocked, cracked arms to defend himself as you step forward. The undead dwarf looks quickly over its shoulder, his gaze darting from shadow to shadow.
Of course, anything, just name it.
What? Source?
The skeleton slowly lowers his arms, staring at you in disbelief.
Of course! You're Godwoken! You seek power! Ultimate power! And I worried we could not find common ground. Yes, Godwoken, I can teach you. If you swear you won't banish me to the afterlife. Am I not? How many others have survived the Magister's witch hunt?
The skull before you curls into a maggot-eating grin.
No, you need me. So I teach you and you spare me. Do we have an accord? Praise be. Very well, Godwoken. Listen carefully. Source and void, day and night, love and hate. One is meaningless without the other. To grow your source, to achieve your potential, you must embrace the void.
The grinning skeleton reaches into the folds of his robes and pulls out a small black mass. It's covered in veins and oozing pus.
Here, Godwoken. Take a bite. The finest meal you'll find in this cave. The heart of a Voidwoken.
Your guard stirs, pushing you to eat it. Do not fear, a voice whispers. Do what must be done.
Perhaps not the most appetizing thing around, but if you truly want to channel more source...
The skeleton extends his arm, jiggling the heart towards you. A glob of dark yellow pus oozes through the bones of his palm and drips to the ground. The thick pus explodes into your mouth, coating the back of your throat. You can feel it running down your throat like rancid custard. You start to retch, your body struggling to reject this intruder, but your teeth clamp down hard on the fibrous, gritty flesh as you force yourself to chew and swallow. Deep within you, you feel something change. Your soul opens up, and you feel it swell as new channels for source start to flow through you. You swallow all you can, and despite the meat in your stomach, you feel a new space inside you, a potential waiting to be filled.
There, I held up my end of the bargain. I did as you asked, and now I'm getting as far from this cave as my bones will take me.
Mordus looks at you in alarm.
God's graves, please be quick. He wanted the death fog destroyed. Once he knew his rats had found it in the Peacemaker's wreck, he wanted it destroyed. The greatest weapon Rivellon has ever seen lands in his lap, and he ordered the barrels thrown into the ocean.
We couldn't let it happen. We needed it. So I took control. I can't. He'll hear.
He'll know. He'll find me. He'll come.
So ask, and let me go.
The skeleton wrings his hands, looking around him.
So I'm free to go.
As he turns away, the skeleton hesitates. He turns back to you, thrusting a golden amulet into your hand.
Take this, and buy passage on a boat that will take you far, far away, Godwoken. His eye is on you, and I don't want to be anywhere near you when he blinks.
With a last suspicious look, Mordus hunches over and hurries away.
I've never felt so alive.
You feel newfound powers of the source course wildly through your body. Deep inside your soul, your god calls for you. It would be wise to meet with your god again by performing the Meister's ritual, here or in Siva's vault. The thought of death fog gives you pause. A weapon like that should give everyone pause.
A weapon of untold destruction? And you use this against your own kind, knowing it ends their existence? How efficient.
Who wakes up in the morning and thinks, today I'll invent something that'll be able to murder people by the hundreds?
This scourge, this destroyer of my people, should be wiped from the face of the earth.
The ghost stares down at his broken, twisted body, a look of glum resignation on his face.
It ain't a pretty way to go, mind you. Could be a damn sight better than whatever Lohar would have done if he'd got his hands on us. Mind control or no, he'll be livid when he finds out what we did.
I'm so sorry. I didn't want to hurt you. I didn't want to hurt anyone. But he made me. That voice. He made me. I let him out of the vault. I killed anyone that got in the way. And then I sat here as he gibbered about needing to complete his bloody Mord'Akaim. Damned if I know. Some ancient ritual, he said. It gave him the power to twist our minds, to turn us into his puppets. And when he was strong enough, it turned him into... that. He thought it was a reward. Kept saying how blessed he was. What madness!
The ghost turns to you, her finger urgently pointing towards something unseen. Silent lips move, issuing an urgent, unheard plea. Your hands merge together, your world twisting, Looking down, you see you're holding a barrel marked with a fatal warning. Death fog. A cart contains many barrels more, recovered from a wrecked ship. The room is filled with voices, cracking jokes and swearing oaths as you go about unloading the cart. But somewhere, in the hum of voices, one cuts through the rest. Stop, it hisses. Do your duty. You lift up the death fog, and, fighting against every step, you walk back to the cart. You pass a dwarf, struggling against the voice and winning. But you crack his skull with a barrel in your hands. One by one, the barrels are loaded again, and the cart departs. As it trundles out of the cave, the voice returns. Come, come to me. And you feel your feet carrying you into the cavern's darkness.
This again. Junk. Letter with a dwarf's seal. Boring.
Fine paper. It looks important.
The dwarf's royal seal? It couldn't be. Open it at once. This could be valuable.
Boring.
You thought Rivellon was flat.
Boring.
Worry about it, says Loha. Quietest work around, says Loha. Well, I don't see him here. Cold stone he's lying on. It will be fine, my ass. And here I was, the fool, believing him.
The ghost swings a foot to kick its old body in frustration, but the boot sails straight through her corpse.
Because it's his fault. If not for him, I'd still be sitting there, wine in hand, happy as Larry. But no, he knew best. He wanted the death fog destroyed. That's why we were to make sure it got into the right hands. Our hands! I even stood guard of Mordus when he was doing nothing but the Queen's bidding. No wonder we came to this. This is what I deserve for following the orders of a leader with the spine of a sponge. Thank Duna Her Majesty is more steel in her belly than that coward. You're a little tool to be asking questions like that. Her Majesty is trying to do what's best for the dwarf people. And there's not a thing more you need to know.
Even dead, I don't get no peace. You need something. What's it look like? Either there were a void-woken attack, or this is the most unfortunate dinner party you ever did see. Now shove off. I've got an afterlife to enjoy, and your jabbering ain't making it easy. Walk on, heartbeat. I got nothing to say to you.
The dwarf pulls a dagger with shocking dexterity and reflexively swings at your gut. Thankfully, the ephemeral blade passes right through you. With a rancid look, the dwarf pockets the knife. As he does so, you spot the royal seal of the dwarven queen on the handle. Through gritted teeth, the dwarf growls.
We're done here.
melting away. Mord'Akaim turned the key into an amulet. Cunning.